to celebrate, and we of course also have very important dignitaries among us, so we respect that as well. But being islanders, we of course love to celebrate. So celebrate we shall today. And so to start us off, may I please ask one of our local groups from were led by Pastor Rufus to please come on up and open up our entertainment for us today. Pastor Rufus, please. Please give them a, thank you, a round of applause.
Highlight.
Thank you.
Alexa, Pastor Rufus, and group. I would like right now to call upon another very special group, and I will try to pronounce their name correctly. I think they're called the Mokiloa Chupi Ki Parano Warriors. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the Mokiloa Chupiki Parano Warriors.
Just a short correction. It's Mokila, not Mokilawa, Mokila.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. And again, correction is Mukhila, right? Yeah, it's a typo. It's a typo. But anyway, thank you very much, Warriors. Thank you. Thank you very much. At this point, I would like to call upon someone who will represent our Native people here. It's only appropriate that we hear from them, we recognize them, because they are indeed the host of all of us here. And if I may call upon Renee Perry to please come on up and say a few words, if you may please. Thank you. Thank you.
CFT. My name is Renee Perry. I'm a citizen of Tlingit Haida Nation in Southeast Alaska. I'm from the Raven Boati on my father's side and the Wolf Clan on my mother's side. I'm a tribal citizen, guest resident here in what is Portland, Oregon, the home to the descendants and the living ancestry of the Chinook people. I'm coming to you today as the executive director of Portland All Nations Canoe Family. We are an indigenous-led intergenerational organization. All of our programming is around traditional canoe culture. So I'd just like to welcome you all as our relatives of the Ocean Canoe people. And I'm very happy to be here today to build our kinship with you. So welcome and thank you very much. Budachish.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Ms. Renee Perry. Do we have any Yapis here? Anybody from the cultural financial capital of the world? Anybody from Yap? What about Koshrai? Yes, we have some Koshrai. Thank you. Thanks for coming, Koshrai. Kulo maalala ketoko lawasan. If I didn't say that right, just be nice. You don't have to be honest. Anybody from, of course, I think we have people from the capital island of Port Bay, right? Can you make some noise? Clap your hands. Very good. What should I say, Pontian? I don't want to mess up again like I messed up on Mukiloa. But I think we say, how do you say thank you for coming? Kalanganan kumwal ketstoran wet. Kalangan. From Chuuk? Anybody from Chuuk? Very good. Yeah, if you think you're from Chuuk, or if you kind of think you might be from Chuuk, but not really sure. We're happy to have you here today. So thank you all very much. At this point, I would like to, I think this is actually the part, aside from the actual ribbon cutting, this is the part that we've been waiting for, the keynote speech. And if I can call upon our Consul General, Joanne, to come on up and introduce our keynote speaker, His Excellency, the President of the Federated States of Micronesia. CG, please come on up. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Portland. It's a little weak, so let me do it again. And I would like for us to strengthen that shout so that Micronesians back in Micronesia can hear. So please, good afternoon, Portland. Yeah. All right. friends, families, distinguished guests. It is a very distinct honor for me to introduce a very special guest with us here, but not a stranger to this part of the world. I met His Excellency David W. Panuelo before he was Excellency, and we met right here in the Pacific Northwest. Back then, he was a businessman, a regular citizen, but I will tell you, I was really moved and touched because he treated me like I was somebody. He treated me like I was a very special person and came out and did lunch with me, even though I was just a regular Joe. But that has been something that has captivated my heart because of this man and what he is and who he is to many of us, people of the islands, as well as the people of the great nation of the United States of America. So this friendship has led us to be paddling the same canoe, the canoe that is symbolic of the canoes that our ancestors used to traverse the world over. So let me introduce to you all the man of the hour, His Excellency David W. Panuelo, President of the great nation of the Federated States of Micronesia. Can we stand and give him a round of applause?
What a beautiful day it is. Kaselelye mango, rananim, mogedin, lenwo, avade, aloa, talova, kiorana. I bring you warm greetings from our capital, the Federated States of Micronesia, which I coined to be paradise in our backyard. Most countries, you will have to travel long distance to find paradise. In our case, in the Federated States of Micronesia, paradise is just right in our backyards. Before I begin my remarks, I want to, on behalf of our entire nation and our beautiful people, recognize leaders and friends who are based, present with us today. But before I do that, Joe, our Consul General, my dear friend, thank you for the kind words. I wish to recognize first our dear friend, the Honorable Ted Wheeler, whom I had the opportunity of meeting in my previous visits, Mayor of the great city of Portland. Let's give him a round of applause, please. In our list of friends who are here, let us also recognize the Honorable Masaki Shika, Consul General of Japan, and Mrs. Shika. Let's give them a round of applause. In my capacity as President of the Nation and in my previous capacities, we have a very strong Kizuna, special bond with the government and the people of Japan. I also wish to recognize people who have visited here, leaders, the Honorable Elton Alec, the Consul General of RMI, based in Arkansas, which is a neighbor, sister island of the Federated States of Micronesia. Let's give him a round of applause, please. Let us also give a round of applause to the Honorable Carlos Quesnel, the Consul General of Mexico. We've had over 20 years of diplomatic relations with Mexico. Let's please give him, our friend, a round of applause. Also here are dear friends from the Oregon State Legislature, and I'm glad to also welcome and recognize the Honorable K.C. Chama, Oregon State Senator. Let's give him a round of applause, please. Let us also recognize a good friend of mine whom I've had the opportunity of meeting, the Honorable Michael Tembrell, Oregon State Legislature. Let's give him a round of applause. And thank the two gentlemen and their colleagues for the excellent work they've been doing in partnering with the Federated States of Micronesia and the Freely Associated States in the work they do in the legislative process of helping partners like our islands, the Federated States of Micronesia. Thank you, my friends, dear senators who are here. Also with us, a good friend and a friend of the consulate office, Joe, the Honorable Judge Sin Lasabai, Multnomah County District Court. Let us welcome her and give her a round of applause. Thank you. Also, let us recognize the Honorable Patrick Allen, Director of Oregon Health Authority. Let's give him, our friend, a round of applause. Also, here, a good buddy of mine, because I believe she's also a Eastern Oregon University buddy, the Honorable Doc Senolei Kilevsky. Let's give her a round of applause. Director of Office of Immigrant and Refugee Advancement, and also the official rep for Governor Kate Brown. Let us also recognize Mr. Chuck Lovell. I met him inside there, a fine gentleman and a friend, Chief of Police of the Portland Police Bureau. Let's welcome him. Before I move further in my remarks, I want to introduce our officials who are also present with us here. Very important officials that I'd like to us to recognize and introduce to our community and friends. First Lady, who have been always by my side, First Lady Patricia Edwin. Let's give her a round of recognition, please. Also, being here, standing in this very land where the consulate is present here, it wouldn't have been possible if it were not to be the support of the Congress of the Federated States of Micronesia. And here we have the Honorable Fiki Kulan, Chairman of the TCNI Committee of the 22nd FSM Congress. Let us give him a round of applause. Because we are a sovereign nation dealing with another sovereign nation, today our ambassador to the United States traveled with me and Mrs. Susaya. Let us introduce and recognize our ambassador to the United States, His Excellency Aquilino Susaya and Mrs. Susaya. A brother-in-law of mine and secretary of the Department of Transportation, Communications, and Infrastructure, the Honorable Carlson Happis. Let us give him a round of recognition. I have to follow protocol, but the boss here is none other than Joe Enlet, the Honorable Joe Enlet, who is the Council General of the Federated States of Micronesia, Portland, Oregon. And I also recognize the fine lady, spouse and partner, Lynn Enlet. And with you, the entire team here at our consulate office here in Portland. Thank you all. Bear with me just a little bit more. We have just a couple more of our delegation who traveled with me from Washington, D.C. I'd like to introduce our press secretary and acting chief of staff, Richard Clark, who's a former Peace Corps to the Federated States of Micronesia, and the person who's responsible in keeping our nation so transparent with news, and every major item that goes on in our capital is known to our citizens, because the business of the people is the business of the government, or the business of the government is the business of the people. So you must know what is happening in our country. Let us give Richard a round of applause, please. Deputy Assistant Secretary of Department of Foreign Affairs, Calvin Emmes. Let's also welcome him to this land here. Last but not the least, First Secretary at our FSM Embassy in Washington, D.C., Raleigh Willie from the state of Kushai. It's called the Sleeping Lady. Raleigh? And I want to conclude my recognition by recognizing each and every one of you, our dear FSM citizens who are from the Pacific Northwest, and those of you who traveled some distance to come here to celebrate this very happy occasion. We welcome you to your consulate office, and you know, by virtue of the Vienna Convention on Diplomatic Relations, the way it's done, our embassy in Washington, D.C., and our consulate office here is the soil of the Federated States of Micronesia, and we reciprocate that to other embassies that are present in our country. So when you are here, you are actually in the Federated States of Micronesia, because the jurisdiction is Federated States of Micronesia. Thank you all, and welcome to this program. Consul General Joe, I thank you most dearly. I know that this office was actually opened several years ago when I was a member of Congress, and we traveled here, met with the then Speaker of the Legislature, Oregon Legislature, Tina Kotek, and then other leaders, where we worked to make sure that the establishment of the consulate office is possible. But it held on, and then the issue of COVID lockdown throughout the world, he held on until this visit so that we may have the opportunity to celebrate together. Thank you, Joe, my friend. This is today, on this historical and lovely occasion, we celebrate the opening of our FSM consulate here in the beautiful state of Oregon. The First Lady and I are most honored to join you today in celebrating the dedication of the office building for the FSM Consulate General here in Portland. As a former longtime resident of Oregon and the Pacific Northwest, I look back on my own personal journey with distinct honor and renewed pride in our young nation. Reflecting on this historic milestone, I initially came to Oregon many years ago as a college student at Eastern Oregon University. our EOU friends. I remember taking the Greyhound bus from downtown Portland, going through small towns like Hood River, beautiful place, to Hermiston. I still remember these towns very vividly. Pendleton, Oregon, and then to La Grande, Oregon. But you know, one of the things that really captured me was when I entered the small town of Oregon, coming from a small island, there was a big sign that I read, and it says, turn your clocks 100 years back, you're entering the town of La Grande. I was gonna ask if it is still the same way today. While I was a member of Congress, one of the stories, short stories I want to share is that I received a call from the president of the Eastern Oregon University. It was passed through the embassy, and then they said that he was trying to reach me. And when I got the message, the first thought that came to my head was, oh my dear, did I pay off my tuitions at that university? Little did I know that it was an invitation for me to come to the commencement ceremonies as an alum for that Eastern Oregon University. And we traveled in June 2017, and it was an honor coming back to speak to the graduating students at Eastern Oregon University. In my college years, it never dawned on me that one day in my adult years, I would come back to Oregon to witness the formalization, strengthening of the cordial ties between the people of Micronesia and the state of Oregon and the Pacific Northwest as president of your country. If I may, I wish to express my gratitude for the friendship so generously extended to me during my maiden journey to this part of the world. And it is a fortune of history for me to come back to celebrate with you all today on this historic and auspicious occasion. So let me turn and say and give some recognition, few recognitions here, especially to our dear citizens in the Pacific Northwest for the advocacy that you've done in helping to make the decision to open a consulate office here in Portland. I want to especially thank the COVA Alliance National Network and the leaders for their advocacy, because it was in fact the delegation from Congress, when I was a member of Congress, we met this group which advocated that because Portland and the Northwest is the biggest diaspora of our population, that we must open a consulate office, and here we are today. So congratulations to all of you, our citizens. I want to also thank WOW, which is We Are Oceania, as an example of citizen-led advocacy group that's doing good work out of Honolulu and covering a lot of the migrant communities and every work that's humanitarian related and support that is so useful to our new immigrant groups in Hawaii and beyond. I want to also thank the FSM Coalition USA as an example of citizen-led advocacy group doing good work in our region here. I want to especially thank the City of Portland and the State of Oregon for their partnership and assistance, Mayor, Senators who are here. Our appreciation cannot be emphasized more. We thank you very much. I also thank the Oregon Health Authority for their close partnership with the FSM community during the COVID pandemic times that we've all endured up to this point. You know, I don't know if you all know, but despite our being a very sovereign nation, we are part of the homeland, which is the United States of America. And last year I met the Hawaii governor, Governor Hike, and he said, hey, President, did you know that your country received the
COVID vaccines before the state of Hawaii? And I said, oh yeah? Now, I want to give you a sense of the close alliance that we have with the United States of America. And I'll visit some of those in the course of my remarks. There are precious few opportunities to provide substantive updates to our citizens on the items that are most important to you. I will therefore seize this opportunity, if you may bear with me and be patient, on this historic occasion to provide you, my dear citizens, some of the few highlights that are happening in our country or in the Banuela George administration. You may be aware that I've just arrived here a few days ago from Washington, D.C., and this visit is very historic and also important because when I came into the administration of the Banuela George administration, the first order of business was an invitation from President Trump to the Micronesian countries. And within the first week of my being sworn in, I traveled to Washington, D.C. because we have such a thing that is called a treaty, which is very unique. It's called the Compact of Free Association. And the United States has that treaty with the freely associated states of the Federated States of Micronesia, Palau, and the Republic of the Marshall Islands. So, a few days ago, I met the National Security Advisor to President Biden, and also a very special individual who's from Portland, the Pacific Northwest, and he is Special Presidential Envoy, appointed by President Biden as the new chief negotiator for our negotiations under the treaty that we are currently working on. And so, on April 21st, the FSM formally submitted to the U.S. Presidential Special Envoy for Combat Negotiations, His Excellency Joseph Yun, our comprehensive combat economic assistance package. In particular, aside from expansion in our health, education, and infrastructure sectors, I am pleased that the U.S. has so far been positively responsive to our proposed environmental sector, which would address climate change in our country, which remains our most significant existential security threat. And this is very unique, a special sector component of our treaty with the U.S. to recognize the impact of climate change to our small island countries. In a readout to me just a day ago from our chief negotiator, it was described that the initial 4 hours long discussion was highly positive and beneficial. Ambassador Yun describes our negotiations as a familial relationship, which is very true. The people and government of the FSM are family with the people and government of the United States. And it is a blessing to know that our enduring partnership with our first and foremost ally continues to grow stronger with every passing moment. Both the FSM and the United States intend to extend our compact economic provisions for another 20 years, and both of our governments also intend to complete the negotiations just before the fiscal year, so that we can turn in the package to both the U.S. Congress and our FSM Congress for approval before the end of the fiscal year, FY 2023. When I came into office in 2019, one of my promises to each and every one of you was to ensure that negotiations will occur and be successful. And we are well on our way towards securing this for the benefit of both of our countries. While most of you are citizens who are here